comma. It's 1976. There are three people that you need to be concerned with. We have Moses, and he is a very wealthy pachinko parlor owner. Pachinko is a vertical gambling game in Japan. I think most of this audience knows what it is. Then you have his son Solomon, who was a little boy. He's about 14 years old. And then we have Etsuko, who is the Japanese girlfriend of Moses, and she runs a restaurant. So we have Moses, pachinko parlor owner, his son Solomon, teenage boy, and we have Etsuko, the Japanese restaurant owner and girlfriend of Moses, 1976 Yokohama. We can do this. We are creative. The Yokohama Ward office was a giant gray box with an obscure sign. And the first clerk that they saw was a tall man with a narrow face and a shock of black hair buzzed off at the sides. And he stared at Etsuko shamelessly, his eyes darting across her breasts, her hips, and her jeweled fingers. She was overdressed compared to Moses and Solomon, who wore white dress shirts, dark slacks, and black dress shoes. And they looked like the gentle Mormon missionaries who used to glide through her village on their bicycles when she was a girl. Your name? The clerk squinted at the form that Solomon was filling out. Solomon. What kind of name is that? It's from the Bible. He was a king and the son of David and a man of great wisdom. My great uncle named me. And the boy smiled at the clerk as if he was sharing a secret. He was a very polite boy, but because he had gone to school with Americans in an international school, sometimes he said things that a Japanese would never have said. Soramon. King. Great wisdom. Koreans don't have kings anymore. What did you say? Etsuko said. And quickly, Moses pulled her back. And she glanced at Moses. His temper was far worse than hers. Once, when a restaurant guest had tried to make her sit with him, Moses, who happened to be there that night, walked over, picked him up bodily, and threw him outside the restaurant, breaking the man's ribs. And right now, she was expecting no less of a reaction. But Moses averted his eyes and he stared at Solomon's right hand. And Moses smiled. Excuse me, sir. We're in a hurry because it's the boy's birthday. Is there anything that we should do? Thank you very much for understanding. And confused, Solomon turned to Etsuko and she flashed him a warning look. And the clerk pointed to the back of the room and told Moses and Etsuko to sit down. And Solomon remained standing opposite the clerk and in the long rectangular room shaped like a train car with bank teller windows running parallel along opposite walls. Half a dozen people sat reading their manga or newspapers, and Etsuko wondered if they were all Korean. And Moses sat down and he got up again and he asked if she wanted a can of tea from the vending machine. And she nodded yes. She felt like slapping the clerk's face. In middle school, she had once slapped a girl who was very gossipy. And it had been very satisfying. When Moses returned with their tea, she thanked him. You must have known. You must have warned him, eh? I mean, you told him that today would not be so easy, eh? And after the words came out, they sounded harsh. She felt sorry. No, I didn't say anything to him. and he opened and he closed his fists rhythmically. I came here with my mother and my brother when I was a boy for my first registration papers. And the clerk was normal, nice even. So I asked her to come. I thought maybe having a woman, a Japanese woman, might help. And he exhaled through his nostrils. It was stupid to wish for kindness. No. You couldn't have warned him. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said it like that. It is hopeless. I cannot change his fate. He is Korean, and he has to get those papers. And he has to follow all the steps of the law perfectly. Once, at a ward's office, a clerk told me that I was a guest in his country. But you and Solomon were born here. Yes, and my brother Noah too. And Moses covered his face with his hands. Anyway, the clerk wasn't wrong. And this is something that Solomon must understand. We can be deported. We have no motherland. Life is full of things that he cannot control. So he must adapt. My boy has to survive. And Solomon returned to them. And next he had his photograph taken. And afterward, he had to go to the next room to get fingerprinted. And then they could go home. And the last clerk was a pretty woman with a very long ponytail. And she took Solomon's left index finger and gently dipped it into a pot filled with thick black ink. And Solomon depressed his finger onto the white card as if he was a child painting. And Moses looked away, and he sighed. And the clerk told him to pick up the registration card in the next room. Let's get your dog tags, Moses said. Solomon faced his father. It's what we dogs must have. And the clerk looked furious suddenly. The fingerprints and the registration cards are vitally important for government records. There's no need to be insulted by this. It is an immigration regulation required for foreign. And Etzko stepped forward. But you don't make your children get fingerprinted on their birthday, do you? And the clerk's neck turned red. My son is dead. And Etzko bit her lip. She didn't want to feel anything for this woman. But she knew what it was like to lose your children. It was like you were cursed, and that nothing would ever restore the desolation of your life. Koreans do a lot of good for this country, Etzko said. They do the difficult jobs that the Japanese don't want to do. They pay taxes and they obey laws. They raise good families, they make jobs. You Koreans always tell me this. And Solomon blurted out, she's not Korean. And Etzko touched his arm. And the three of them walked out of the building. She wanted to crawl out of the gray box and see the light of outdoors again. She longed for the white mountains of Hokkaido. And though she had never done so in her life, she wanted to walk in the cold snowy forests beneath the flanks of the dark leafless trees. In life, there was so much insult and injury. And she had no choice but to collect what was hers. But now, she wished to take Solomon's shame and add it to her pile. Though she was already so overwhelmed. Thank you.